Very good morning, cadets. Hope you are all doing well. The last video session, very interesting story about Lakshmi. She took a different job of railway engine driver in the Northern Railways Government of India. Okay. Now, it is important to understand that we live in a society in which all children face pressure from the world around them. Sometimes these come in the form of demands from adults. At other times, they can just be because of unfair teasing by our own friends. So, as a young children, we come across a lot of pressure. Pressure may be from adults or maybe from our friends, teasing from our own friends. Boys are pressurized to think about getting a job and that will pay good salary. And they are also teased and bullied if they do not behave like a boy. It's very important. If a boy behaves like a girl, he will be teased. Okay, you remember that in your class 6 you have read about how boys in the early age encourage not to cry in front of others. Read the story below and the answer question. If you were Xavier, what subject would you choose and why? In your own experience, what are some other pressures that boys experience? Keep these two questions in your mind. Let us go through the storyboard. Xavier was happy with the result of his class 10th board examination. Though his marks in science and maths were not high, he had done well in his favorite subject, history and language. When his parents saw his report card, however, they did not look pleased at all. This is a very common scene nowadays, because neglecting all other subjects and giving importance only to maths and science. Oh my goodness, Xavier, have you managed only 65% in maths? Your marks in physics are too low. He says, I know, Mama, but it's okay because I don't want to take maths and science. I want to study history. So, what this child says, I know my marks are less in science. That too, I am scored very low in physics because I don't want to continue study maths and science. I want to continue history. Now, see the reaction of father. Why do you want to take history? Think about future. This father concludes that if he studied history, his future is ended there and there only. You have to get a good job. History will not help. There is no scope. Often we come across this word called scope. What do you mean by scope? Scope is nothing but job market. It is believed that if you studied science, engineering, maths, all these courses will offer you good job. Good job will lead to salary. This is our general societal behavior. So he says that if you study history, there is no scope. But of course, you can become an archaeologist, you can become Office and Archaeological Survey Department of India, or you can do a lot of research in that subject also. But those things are very rare or less known to the people. But I don't like maths and science. This child says, no, I don't study science because I don't like maths and science. Then he said, be sensible son, take maths. You can study computers side by side, and the job market for computers is very good. This is what I said. Why you have to study maths? why you have to study computer, why you have to study engineering, not because you want to study or you are interested to study. Because you have to study because the job market is good. That means you can get a job. That is the reason why you have to study. So what you understood by this storyboard? The storyboard clearly says that even our education system also, where we have got a stereotyped thoughts, where we are not allowing the kids to take the subject of their choice. We are making the kids to learn the subject of our choice or the choice of job market. This is the story of 21st century. Now let us go back and let us understand what is the condition of India in 18th and 19th century. Okay. Please observe the two images. Okay. Okay. Ramabai. Okay. She was called as Pandita Ramabai. Okay. You may be studying in Sanskrit. Ramabai, 1858 to 1922. Shown above with her daughter. With her daughter. Champion the cause of women's education. Ramabai, she was popularly known as Pandita Ramabai, fought for women's upliftment, for women's education. She never went to school, but learned to read and write from her parents. So normal schooling, what today girls and boys attend, normal schooling, I am talking BC is before Corona. Today nobody attends school, we are all studying online. But Ramabai, of course, she didn't have an opportunity to attend school. She learned how to read and write from her parents. She was given a title, Pandita, that is what I said. Please write down all these details. Pandita Ramabai, 1858 to 1922. She was given the title because she could read and write Sanskrit. Please, why Pandita Ramabai was given title Pandita? Because she could read and write Sanskrit. Remarkable achievement as a woman then were not allowed for such knowledge. Because in those days, means during the time of Pandita Ramabai, that time women were not allowed to learn all those things. She went on, set up a mission in Khedegaon near Pune in 1898, where widow and poor women were encouraged not only to become illiterate but also become independent. Please understand this sentence, very very important. Pandita Ramabai felt that women in India are exploited, harassed, or suffer under domestic violence, suffer because of domestic violence, purely because they are illiterate and they are not economically independent. I repeat, economically independent. If someone is educated and earning her own income, then the chance of exploitation is less, because she is an empowered woman. Empowered women, it's very difficult to harass. They were taught a variety of skills, from carpentry, running printing press, and other skills. The printing press can be seen in the picture of the left to the corner. Ramabai mission is still active today. So, in the picture, that is a printing press is shown, and this printing press is still active today. Let us go back to the picture once again. You see, this is the printing press. You can see the printing press. You can see the printing press. And you can see here all those who are working. They are all women here. Okay. So Pandita Ramabai. Imagine, this is not the story of 2020. It's not like that. It's the story of 1898. The story of 1898. Okay. Now, you see, 1898. So she started homes for widow as well as started them teaching, making them literate and independent. That is the greatest achievement of Pandita Ramabai. What you would understand here is, one lady, even though she is not got formal education, but because she learnt because of her own efforts. Let us move to the further modules. Learning for change. Going to school is an extremely important part of your life. As more and more children enter school every year, we begin to think that it's normal for all children to go to school. Today, it's difficult for us to imagine that school learning could have seen out of bond or not appropriate for some children. Now you see, this book is written maybe 20 years back. When the book is written, nobody thought the corona day will come where school will be out of bond. Today we are living in a time where schools are really out of bond for the kids, not because of social bonding, it's purely because of pandemic COVID. But those days school was out of bond, that women or the girl children were not allowed to attend the school because it was out of bounds for them. But in the past, the skills of reading and writing was known only for few. Most children learnt the work, their families, and what the elders did. So what was normal job of a children? They used to learn the work what the elders did. For girls, the situation was worse. Now the point. So the girls, the situation was worse. The communities that taught sons to read and write, daughters were not allowed to learn the alphabet. Please write down all these points. The community which supporting the sons, the male children, to read and write, but the daughters were not allowed to learn an alphabet. Even families where skills like pottery, weaving, craft were taught. The contribution of daughters and women was only seen as supportive. Please understand this. So daughter and women, they are only seen as supportive. That means they were not allowed to take major role. They can do only supporting role for any job. They were not allowed to do any major role. For example, in pottery trade, women collected mud and prepared the earth for the pots. But since they did not operate the wheel, they were not seen as potters. Now you see, potter or pottery, making of pots, very important aspect of making of pot, that rotating of wheel. Women were not allowed to rotate the wheel. Since they were not allowed to rotate the wheel, they were not seen as potters, but they used to do the work. In 19th century, many new ideas about education and learning emerged. Schools became more common, and the communities that had never learnt reading and writing started sending their children to the school. But there were a lot of opposition for the girl children even then. Yet many women and men made efforts to open schools for girls. Women struggled to read and write. So it is very uncommon. Okay, so let us read one more experience of Rasundhara Devi, okay, 1800 to 1890, was born in West Bengal. Please write down all these things, nearly 200 years ago. At the age of 60, she wrote her autobiography in Bangla. What do you mean autobiography? Writing about the self is called autobiography. Means if you are writing about your life and achievement, you yourself writing, it is autobiography. Her book title Amar Jiban. Okay, Amar Jiban, please write down this also. What is the name of the book written by Rasundhara Devi is Amar Jiban. Is the first known autobiography written by an Indian woman. So see the achievement. It was known, first known autobiography written by an Indian woman. Rasundhara Devi was a housewife from the rich landlord's family. At the time, it was believed that if a woman learned read and write, she would bring bad luck to her husband and become widow. What a pathetic thinking, you see. Those days they used to think if a woman goes to school and learn, then she will definitely bring bad luck to her husband, her husband will die and she will become widow. But even though this kind of tough thinkings were there, she taught herself how to read and write in secret after her marriage. So greatest achievements than few women, and that's the reason even after 200 years we are studying about them. That is the, because time is immortal, people may mortal, because we have our own limited period. But today also we are studying about this particular aspects because this lady has done something extraordinary. Today if you go to school and write an autobiography, it is not an extraordinary, because it's an ordinary thing anyone can do. But since it was not encouraged those days, that's the reason why it is considered one of the important aspects. I would start looking at dawn and I would still be at it until well beyond midnight. I had no rest in between. I was only 14 years old at the time. I came to nurture a great longing. I would learn to read and I would read religious manuscripts. I was unlucky. In those days, women were not educated. So this is the word. I began to resent my own thoughts. What is wrong with me? Women do not read. How will I do it? Then I had a dream. I was reading a manuscript, Chaitanya Bhagavat. Please write this manuscript, name of manuscript, Chaitanya Bhagavat. Later in days, as I sat cooking in the kitchen, I heard my husband say to my eldest son, Bipin, I have left my Chaitanya Bhagavat here. When I ask for it, bring it. He left the book there and went away. When the book had been taken inside, I secretly took out a page and hid it carefully. It was a job hiding it, for nobody must find it in my hand. My eldest son was practicing his alphabets at that time. I hid one of them as well. At time I went over that trying to match letters from the page which the letter that I remembered. I also tried to match the words with those that I would hear in the course of my days. With a tremendous care and effort and over a long period of time, how I learned how to read. You see how difficult it to undergo, how difficulties they used to undergo is an experience. After learning alphabet, Rasundhara Devi was able to read Chaitanya Bhagavat. So she able to read Chaitanya Bhagavat through her own writing. She also gave a word of an opportunity to read about women's life in those days. She wrote about her everyday life experience in detail. There were days when she did not have a moment to rest, no time even to sit down and eat. But today you see, compare your condition, because she didn't had a time to rest, or even that is what even she didn't had a time to sit down and eat. In that pathetic condition also, or situation also, she had an interest to learn. Unlike Rasundhara Devi and Rukya Shekhawat Hussain, who were not allowed to learn to read and write, large number of girls attend school in India today. Despite this, there is a continuous continue to be many girls who leave school of reason of poverty. So why there is a dropout in school? Mainly because of poverty and inadequate school facilities and discrimination in providing equal schooling facilities to children from all communities and class background. Class in the sense rich or poor. And particularly girls continue to be a challenge in India. Means the girls' education is a big challenge in India. Schooling and education today. Today both boys and girls attend school in large number. Yet, as we will see, there still remain difference between education of boys and girls. India has a census every 10 years which counts the whole population of the country. It also gathers detailed information about people living in India, their age, their schooling, what work they do, and so on. We use this information to measure many things like number of literate people and the ratio of men and women. According to 1961 census, about 40% of all boys and men were illiterate, compared to just 15% of all girls and women. The most recent census of 2001, these figures have grown to 76% of boys and men and 54% of for girls and women. This means that proportion of both men and women who are now able to read and have at least some amount of schooling has increased. But as you can also see, the percentage of male group still higher than the female group. Okay, let us check the table. Here is a table that shows the percentage of girls and boys who leave school, dropouts. What do you mean by leave school? Means dropout. In class 6, 7th and 8th, they leave the school. Dropouts because of various reasons. Scheduled caste and the official term of Dalits, and your scheduled tribe is the official term for Adivasi. Primary class, that is 1 to 5. All boys 34, SC 37, ST 49, girls 29, 36, 49, total 31. Elementary level 52. Okay, so from the elementary you see 57 boys, 69 boys, 53 and total. So you see the percentage, those who leave the school, it is very very huge. And when they comes to secondary, senior secondary, the percentage is still high. So it is clearly indicates that there is a large number of dropout. It's a large number of dropout in the schooling from the side of scheduled caste, scheduled tribe and Adivasis. Okay. Leftover topics will continue in the tomorrow video session. Wish you a wonderful day. Thank you very much.